Our first objective involves being able to integrate rational expressions or rational functions by applying this technique called partial fraction decomposition, where we're taking our rational expression and breaking it into some partial fractions, which are easier to integrate. You can see from this image that somebody has decomposed this lovely automobile into its like component parts. So that's what we want to do with our rational expression, just like we did in the warm-up exercise. So in that warm-up exercise, this is essentially the same exact problem. We got a common denominator here, which was the product of those two denominators since they didn't share a common factor. And then we combine up the two numerators there thusly, right? Combine some like terms, and then perhaps expand out the denominator. Okay, so let's suppose that for whatever reason, this is what we're starting with, and we wanted to work that entire process backwards. Working this process backwards is called partial fraction decomposition, because we're going to take this rational expression and decompose it into two partial fractions that make this thing up, right? So essentially, it's like working this addition or subtraction problem, whatever it is, working it backwards so that we can figure out what the original problem was, right? Hey, where did this thing come from? What was the subtraction problem or addition problem, whatever, that gave rise to that? That's what we're about to do. Okay, so let's start with this equation here. And then step number one is to factor the denominator, not the top, the bottom. You factor the denominator. So that one's pretty easy to do. X plus 2 times x plus 4. Okay, so now we're going to rewrite this as two separate fractions where the denominator must be on the first one, x plus 2, and the denominator on the second one must be x plus 4. Remember, that's exactly where this thing came from. It was the product of those two denominators. Now, we have no idea what the two numerators are, so we're just going to write them with a generic numerator like this, a over x plus 2 plus b over x plus 4. Now, essentially, what we want to do is we want to solve for the a and the b in this problem. So to do that, like I've got a rational equation here. So to solve a rational equation, we want to get rid of all of the fractions, and we can easily do that by just multiplying by the least common denominator. Least common denominator here is just this x squared plus 6x plus 8, because that's exactly what we would get if we multiplied these two denominators on the right side of the equation. Right? So when I do this, notice that the x plus 2 from this a term over here is going to disappear, but it's still going to have a factor of x plus 4. And then also, the x plus 4 in the second fraction is going to cancel out, and it's going to leave me a factor of x plus 2. This is what it's going to look like. This equation is called the basic equation. And what we're going to do is we're going to solve this basic equation for the a and the b. And there are two different ways to solve it, and I'm going to show you the easiest way to solve it. It is a matter of choosing some super convenient values for x, because this equation is supposed to be true for all x's. I'm going to choose something very convenient for x to make either the a or the b disappear. So the first thing that I'm going to choose is x is equal to negative 2, because if I choose x equals negative 2, then that's going to cancel out this term that has the b in it and leave me only with the a term. So here, this is what it's going to look like. I'm going to let x is equal to negative 2 and then do some substitution. This part here is 0, and adding these two together, of course, we get a positive 2a. Over here on the left-hand side, we have 6, and then now it's just a simple matter of division, and we get a is equal to 3. Look how easy that was, right? So I'm going to plug that back into the equation and then do this whole thing again, but think about it. Let's go back up here to the original basic equation. I'm going to choose a different convenient value of x. This time we want the a to disappear. So what value of x should I choose to make a disappear? Obviously, it should be a negative 4. So that's what we're going to do next. We're going to let x equal negative 4 so that we can solve this thing for b. So this a term is going to disappear because that's 0. And then over here, we're going to have a negative 2b. And over here, we're going to have 4. And then again, a simple matter of division gives us b is equal to negative 2. Now we have our A, we have our B. For our basic equation, we plug those things back in order to write the partial fraction decomposition thusly. And notice that this is the exact same problem that we started out with. It's just that I put a little negative sign up here instead of making that a subtraction problem. That's it. That is the process called partial fraction decomposition. So let me actually show you how we use it in a particular problem, right? It has to do with integrating this rational expression. So I look at this and it looks like I could do maybe u substitution here. Let's try this with some u substitution. It looks like it might be u substitution because we don't have a quotient rule for division. However, if you take the derivative of the denominator here, I would have a 2x, I would have linear, which is what we have up top. However, it doesn't exactly match up. So if u was equal to x squared plus 6x plus 8, then du would equal 2x plus 6 dx. So here, like, I can't exactly make this x plus 8 equal this thing that I have down here in the denominator, or the du, right? So it doesn't exactly match up. However, we can apply some partial fraction decomposition to it, and it makes it much simpler. So we just learned through partial fraction decomposition that x plus 8 over x squared plus 6x plus 8 with respect to x should be equal to, I think it was x plus 3, right? What is this extra page? So no, not x plus 3. 3 over x plus 2 and a negative 2 over x plus 4. 3 over x plus 2 minus 2 over x plus 4 dx. And of course, you could separate this as two separate integrals, but the reason why these are easy to integrate, because if you do a little u substitution on each one of these, this one, your u is equal to x plus 2, and your du is equal to just dx. There's nothing to fix there. All right, and then likewise for the second one, u is equal to x plus 4, and then du is equal to just dx. And again, there's nothing to fix here. So these become, when I go to rewrite this in terms of a u substitution, integral of, the 3 gets to stay, and this dx, the dx, I'm going to actually do a dx for each one of these, just becomes a du, and this bottom here becomes a u. So it's like this 3 du over u. And then the same kind of thing here, I will actually, no, that looks like a multiplication, minus integral of a 2 over u, and this is a du. So think about it for a second. What is the antiderivative of du over u? That is the natural log. So this becomes then 3 times the natural log of the absolute value of u minus 2 times the natural log of the absolute value of u as well. But these are different u's. Probably should have used a different variable here anyway. Plus c. And now let's back substitute with the original u expressions. 3 natural log absolute value of x plus 2, I believe, for that first one, and then minus 2 times the natural log absolute value of x plus 4 plus c. Now, in a multiple choice kind of situation, you may have to use some properties of exponents, or properties of logarithms, I should say, in order to rewrite this. So like this 3 could come on the inside of this, this 2 can come on the inside of this, and then you can rewrite this as a division problem. So who knows? It's entirely possible that this one could be rewritten as one complete logarithm, where it was the natural log, absolute value of x plus 2 cubed over x plus 4 squared, and then plus c. It's entirely possible that they write it like that. Okay, so here, let me summarize this process of partial fraction decomposition. So first of all, We didn't see this in our activity that we just completed, but if your fraction is improper, that means that the degree of the top is bigger than the degree of the bottom. The very first thing that you have to do is divide. Long division, synthetic division if it's appropriate, and you only do partial fraction decomposition to the remainder. The other part is just going to be, it's going to be some sort of polynomial. It should be easy to integrate term by term. Okay, so just on the remainder, if it's improper. Otherwise, hey, let's get started on the partial fraction decomposition. You only factor the denominator, you never factor the numerator. So we're going to break up the denominator into its component factors like this on step number 3. For each linear factor in the denominator, write the partial fractions like this: a over the first factor plus b over the second factor. And you can see we have linear factors down here in the denominator. Okay, for however many factors that you have. Most commonly, you have 2, possibly 3. And then next, you're just going to multiply by the common denominator in order to make your basic equation. Now it's time to solve your basic equation. We solve our basic equation by substituting a totally convenient value for x that's going to make one of those variables, a, b, c, those numerator values, just conveniently disappear, okay? And you repeat this process until you find all of those numerator values, all of the a, the b, and the c. And then finally, just rewrite your partial fractions using these new numerator values, just like we just did. Now, there is an alternative way to solve the basic equation. For the ones that you normally have on the AP exam, this is the fastest, most convenient way to solve it. But it's entirely possible, if it gets more complicated, to solve it with a system of equations. And the way that you do that is you expand out your basic equation, and then you equate the coefficients in order to make a system of equations, which you could probably solve with a matrix. I'll show you this alternative technique in an optional video coming soon.